Hey everybody, I'm Clifford Stumpy, the Pop Song Professor, and welcome to my channel where we make English class awesome by talking about song lyrics. And you want to know what I am completely tired of? It is cliches in song lyrics. They're an easy, simple, lazy excuse to not have to put a lot of thought into what somebody is saying, and a lot of times they're used to try to connect with everybody universally because everybody can connect with a cliche. Newsflash, everybody can connect about this much with a cliche because they're boring, trite phrases or words that we have heard so many times there's no room left in most cases to use them creatively. And I love Taylor Swift's music to death, but I was trying to find artists who didn't use cliches, and I was going through some of her songs just in the hopes that I'd be able to say she was one of the good ones. My gosh, it was like a cliche a minute, a cliche a line. Basically anybody who has somebody else write their songs for them, Justin Bieber, Katy Perry, the list goes on. And then there are other artists who just don't really focus on the lyrical content of what they write, so they just slap any old words that come to them as long as it fits the beat and the rhythm, doesn't distract from the music, and they're like, yeah, my fans can just suck it, it's about the music anyway. There's no room for good lyrics in some of these people's music. Before we look at some examples of cliche lyrics in current music and then look at three artists who I recommend because they don't really use cliches or they use them really well, let's ask the question, are cliches actually bad? And here's what some of you guys had to say about this. One of my good buddies, Top 40 Theory, says it depends on how they are used. In good songs, they are used as a grounding element to help convey something that transcends the cliche itself. In not so good songs, they are used as crutches. And I would go so far as to say that they're not even like intentionally being used at all. The person who puts a cliche into a song often doesn't even recognize they're using a cliche. They're just saying the first thing that came to mind instead of trying to think of something good that accomplishes the goal of connecting to the audience well. But sure, cliches can also be used in a good way, and I'm not saying that a good song will never have any cliche in it whatsoever, but a lot of times it's gonna mean that they have very few cliches. And a lot of songwriter type people who focus more on the music are gonna ask me, well, what's the big deal? What's so wrong with cliches? Humans connect to each other through music and through words. If your words suck and don't sound real to you, not only are you missing an opportunity to more deeply connect with your audience and push album sales, but you're also just creating words that aren't really worth hearing. And do you really want to create things that aren't worth hearing? I thought the whole point was to create something people really, really like. So if you say, I'm gonna put all my effort into music, but I'm not gonna touch the lyrics because I just don't care, you realize your audience hears both, right? But I agree with Top 40 Theory here. Cliches can be used well, but I would just caution us all that you don't want to overuse them and you need to intentionally use them, not just let them accidentally slip into your music. Dr. Lee Van Handel, perspective from music cognition. We tend to like music that is familiar, but not too familiar. So if a song uses a cliche, then it provides a certain amount of familiarity immediately. That's a fair point. People are dumb, and so they're going to go and take what is easy to understand over what is complicated to understand immediately. Is that dumbness a bad thing? No, but it's true. We tend towards what is simple rather than what is better. So sometimes a cliche is a good way to say, hey, I'm with you, and then you can take that and do cooler things with it. But again, if it's just cliches, who cares? There's sometimes not a lot of uniqueness, but some pop music is just to have fun while listening to at parties or with friends. I've heard people say this so many times. And on one hand, it's true. A lot of people aren't listening to the lyrics anyway. But on the other hand, I don't care. You can be uncliched and still write a party song, but the fact of the matter exists that if you are putting out things for people to listen to and you don't care about the quality of part of what you're putting out, a very big part, the lyrics, then I just don't have respect for you as an artist. What kind of sculptor says, you know, I'm gonna make the head and the arms of this statue look really, really good, but you know what, most people are just looking at those anyway, I'm not even gonna bother with the legs, who even cares? If you care about your craft, you make the whole thing good. It honestly depends on what cliche is in question. If the cliche is mental health at this day and age, if it's taken seriously by the artist, then I let it slide. If it's comparing someone to a drug, then I'm like, yeah, just stop. Couldn't agree more. And I think that there's two types of cliches. There's cliched words and phrases, and then there's cliched topics. But a cliched topic can be done well if you come at it from a fresh perspective. If you're just saying what everybody else is saying so you can ride the bus and like, oh, hey, look, I care about mental health too. Listen to my music. I'm an activist.
Screw you.
I don't care as long as it sounds good, not gonna lie.
And there's a time and place for music that just sounds good.
But it goes back to integrity as an artist. Who are you as an artist when you're creating something that nobody is paying attention to?
And how are people who do pay attention to your lyrics supposed to take you seriously if you don't take yourself seriously?
Kathy Bishop sums it up nicely. The answer to pretty much every question like that is, it depends. And that is fair. There are gonna be cliches that are a good fit. They're put in there ironically, they're put in there self-referentially, or sometimes people will take a cliche and they'll rework it and interpret it in a new way, which is always super creative and cool, at which point they're basically making it not a cliche because they're doing it so uniquely. My advice to people who want me to listen to their music is just to take your craft seriously and to be intentional about what you choose. Don't just put lyrics down because it was the first thing that comes to your mind. Put lyrics down because it sounds good and makes sense. So let's go ahead and move on to the next portion. Let's talk about some cliche lyrics on the top 100 chart right now. All of these songs have at one point been in the top 10, and all of them are currently on the top 100. The first one is Truth Hurts by Lizzo, and I was expecting tons of cliches in there. I love the song. April has been listening to it a lot, and it's gotten hooked into my head too. But I would say that there are still some cliches in here, even if she doesn't really use them poorly. So we're starting off with kind of a good example. You're supposed to hold me down, but you're holding me back. And even though that is two cliches strung together, she's stringing them together in a way that juxtaposes them. And so it's like they're this cool cliche sandwich, and she makes something new, a new line, a new phrase out of two cliches, which is kind of cool. I just took a DNA test. Turns out I'm 100% that bitch. That bitch is a cliche, but she's referring to it as a cliche itself. And so that's forgiven. Yeah, I got boy problems. That's the human in me. Those are both cliches, but she juxtaposes them in the next line, so it stays interesting. Truth Hurts itself is a cliche, but she's making the whole song about the cliche, so again, it's kind of forgivable because in a sense, it's sort of self-aware. She knows it's a cliche, and she's basically saying throughout the song, yeah, just stick with me. I'm gonna explain this cliche and what it means to me, so it gets unique and really cool. Don't text me, tell it straight to my face. This cliche is boring and not all that interesting. Shampoo press, get you out of my hair. The get you out of my hair would have been a cliche, except she combines it with the shampoo press, and so she's taking this cliche but putting it, she's describing it as her like getting her hair shampooed, and so it makes it more interesting and gives this cliche life. It's like every cliche she touches, she just has like this tire pump and she pushes a little bit more air into it and makes it cool again, which I think is awesome, so good for her. Señorita by Shawn Mendes and Camila Cabello honestly didn't have that many cliches in it. I grabbed every one that I could really think of, but that's mostly because a lot of the lyrics in this song are just kind of sentimental mush and soft nothings. There's just some things that never change. Boring could be describing anything. Don't care. I wish it wasn't so damn hard to leave ya. We've all heard this, I wish it wasn't hard to leave ya kind of idea. Boring, call my name, I'll be coming for ya. The call my name part is the cliched part. And just how many people have said that? And also, the song's name is Señorita. Call my name, Señor. The name's not Señorita anyway. Don't think about it too hard. Ooh, you keep me coming for ya. Again, we've heard that so many times. It's so boring in there. It's just filler nonsense at this point because, you know, we've heard that phrase so many times, it's kind of started to lose meaning. Like when you say a word again and again and again and again until you start to not really understand what the word means or how it puts together and the letters are starting to fall apart and the sounds don't make sense anymore. That's the problem with cliches, is that it happens on a cognitive level where you hear this phrase so many times that it doesn't actually mean anything anymore. It's just like this automatic sign that you keep on driving past. And then of course, the friend zone cliche. You say we're just friends. Woo. Now, I was expecting Post Malone to have very few cliches, but I was unpleasantly surprised in his song Goodbyes. She needs something to change, need to take off the edge. Take off the edge is a common cliche used in reference to substance abuse a lot of times. My girl spites me in vain, all I do is complain. Maybe usually people say all you do is complain, so maybe he's flipping that around a little bit, but it's not that exciting. And we wouldn't let go and we lost it. We wouldn't let go is a cliche, and we lost it is
It's, we lost it. What did you lose? There's a lot of times when you hear a cliche, the problem with it is that it's so vague. It's almost referring to nothing. We lost it. We lost what? And we all kind of know what he means from cultural context, but he's relying on our cultural context knowledge instead of taking the opportunity to describe something realer and more true to him. We lost it. Say that 50 times and I swear you're gonna go insane. But you don't got shit to say. Honestly, probably 90% of swearing usage in rap music or in pop music is going to come down to some kind of cliche. And I'm not like against swearing necessarily, but there's just very few new and interesting ways to use the F-bomb or to use shit in this case. I want you out of my head. That's a prime example of a cliche. I'm no good at goodbyes. The whole tagline of the entire song is a cliche. And no one's gonna knock Post Malone for not being talented. Like, he's a great performer, a great singer, a great rapper. But this is boring. This is so boring. And then now I'm a goner. That's also a cliche. Woo. And then finally, we get to I Don't Care by Ed Sheeran and Justin Bieber. Wondering if I could sneak out the back. They're talking about being at a party and it's too much extrovertedness for all the introverts. Wonder if I could sneak out the back. Why does everybody always have to sneak out the back? Why can't you sneak out the front? Why can't you just leave? And I don't ever wear a suit and tie. Nobody's asking you to. You're just using that because it's a reference to formalness, but it's a lazy reference because you didn't come up with it. It's not original and it's not true to you. It's just lazy. I don't think I fit in at this party. Great, heard it before. Then you take my hand. Oh, this is one of the worst cliches we've seen in this entire video so far. Then you take my hand. And sure, it can be meaningful and can be something that people like singing to and enjoy hearing. I'm not in any way with this entire video saying that you guys shouldn't enjoy a song that has a cliche. You just have to recognize you're doing 90% of the work because they're putting this lazy phrase into a song and then your imagination and brain construct your own personal meaning around it, which is actually kind of cool on a cognitive, psychological, literary level, but the artist themselves is not really doing anything. You're doing all the work. And then finally, actually what may be really the worst, I'm crippled with anxiety. Why crippled? Is it because you've heard that phrase 1,000 times before, crippling anxiety? Like, that is so lazy. Okay, we're gonna bring it back in here and talk about three artists briefly who don't use cliches or who do use them well that I would recommend. So if you're tired of cliches and now after you watch this video you're mad at me because you can only ever hear cliches in music again and it's ruined songs for you, which I hope it hasn't, but if it does, suck it up, I guess. These three artists are ones who I've been listening to recently who do an incredible job of coming up with interesting, unique lyrics that say something in a new way that I've not heard before and that is not reliant on cliches. So the first one is Cave Town, and Robbie sings, "Boys will be bugs." Like, that's the name of the song. He says, "I'm a dumb teen boy. I eat sticks and rocks and mud. I don't care about the government and I really need a hug." Super unique first three lines. The idea of I really need a hug is kind of cliched, but it's almost like this fulfillment of what's come before. So he's got this unique character situation who needs, as the solution to his problem, something very common and almost cliche. It's like it's cliche for a purpose, but he doesn't rely on the cliche. He builds up to the cliche and then earns it by having described it in this unique, cool way. Then you get Pure Gold by Half Alive. Breathe, what defines and describes your worth. Defines your worth is a cliche, but I think they knew that, and so they put describes in between there and break it up. They break it up, which is like very, very smart and very cool. Climb, measure height by the winds, discern, wait for the tides of change will come. A little bit of a cliche that I don't like there, but it kind of goes along with some of the weather imagery that's happening, so it at least fits in. And reach for the sight of being undone. Most people listen to this and they're like, what the heck does that even mean? But they're doing such a good job of describing this stuff in a unique way. And I leave this one in here with kind of that cliche that I don't really like, tides of change, to show you that like having a cliche every once in a while or using it intentionally is not a bad thing. It's just when every line is a cliche or your whole chorus is nothing but cliches, it's oppressive. Then finally, I've got Butterflies by Samsa. Samsa raps to lo-fi hip-hop and ukuleles too, and it's awesome. I don't know if Samsa's still active, but man, He does such a good job with his lyrics of creating these unique situations and this really cool description. There was one song he did, and I'm talking about lo-fi hip-hop tomorrow in the channel, so stick around for that. But he was talking about like how he wanted his girl to haunt him because she died, but he wanted her to haunt him through technology because it seemed more appropriate or something. It was just such a unique, interesting idea. In Butterflies, he's talking about the things he loves about his girl, like the little unique things, and the little unique things he doesn't like. And then, you know, he talks about some of his own problems too. He says, "I think I'm in love," which is maybe a cliched way to start. What would you expect from somebody who's very self-awarely being in love? "But I've been feeling otherwise. These flutters in my stomach aren't butterflies." So like having butterflies in your stomach is a metaphor or is a cliche, but he changes it and he says, no, this isn't the case of a cliche. The cliche is not in here. They are cutting knives, and you know, cutting like a knife is maybe a cliche, but he doesn't use that same phrase here, and he's turning the butterflies into knives. So he's like playing with these cliches like soldiers on this battleground of lyric writing, where he's taking this cliche and saying, no, flip it around, turn it into this one, and then he says, and not the butter kind. So there's always like this cool twist or interesting perspective he puts on it. But yeah, anyway, those are three artists who I think do a really good job of writing lyrics that are not cliche. And I love and enjoy many artists with cliched music. I listen to Kesha. I listen to older Katy Perry. I adore Taylor Swift's music. But if you want powerful lyrics, lyrics that leave you respecting the person who wrote them and feeling like you're connected to them and thinking, wow, those lyrics are really beautiful, and it's not just the music I care about, it's also these lyrics are something that is worth hearing and thinking about, then looking for artists who don't rely on lazy cliches is a really good decision to make. The people who take the time to write lyrics that don't rely on cliches are the people who care about what they're saying, which means they also care about what you think about what they're saying. So when an artist doesn't rely on cliches, it means they care about you as a listener and a person, which I think is the first step towards building a relationship between musician and audience, and between me and my music. Thanks so much for watching, everybody. If you want to keep watching me rant about things and give my unasked for opinion, you can watch my thoughts on why the music industry sucks right here, or why I stopped listening to Christian music. Hint, there's a lot of cliches. But thank you again for watching. Let me know what you think about cliches down below. Don't let my opinion just beat you into agreeing with me. I want to know what you guys think. Thanks for listening and for being here and all that. See you later.